Thank you, Fawzi, Stuart, John, Fahad. Thank you for this amazing panel. Our next presentation is about social business, digital transformation, and employee advocacy by Hootsuite. Please welcome Olivier Cohen, the regional manager in the Middle East of Hootsuite. Thank you.
How it works? Hello. So I'm Olivier. I'm going to talk about digital transformation for Hootsuite. Who knows Hootsuite in the audience, by the way? One, two, three. Okay. Yeah, it's amazing how the company went into Middle East, because we have we have this freemium approach, and you can today open your account of Hootsuite, and it's free. And it will help you to schedule content on social media. It's a scheduler, and it's very useful. But today I'm going to speak about something that resonates very much for Hootsuite, which is digital transformation, and also the impact of that maybe on your business, and what are the ways to take advantage of this digital transformation. We are at a period in time that is extremely special. I think, it never happens like that. It's a massive transformation, and it's all about, this affects different countries via different way, via different form. Maybe the common thing is that somebody will come in your business, change the rule, and he's not from your business, So this is a very new approach. It's affecting everybody. It's funny to see sometimes that, some people lecture about this, but, it's more like we take example of other people, but it's affecting yourself, it's affecting me, it's affecting government, it's affecting companies. It's just a question of time and of speed. So disruption affects people. And it's a mixture of changing in cultural, but also technology. So technology accelerates the change in cultural shifts. And it's important to understand and to capture this very, very specific moment and to feel that. So this is an interesting graph where you have incredible, statistic at the moment. For example, do you realize that in 4 years from now, 50% of the workforce of the world will be millennials, which means people that were born between 1980 and the year 2000. And those people were born, with digital, they are digital native, and it's also changing the way the business is run today, because the need of those people that are going to be, the manager and the leader of tomorrow, and it's already the case for some of them, they don't look at things like me, I was looking at 20 years ago. So this is very, very important. So what are, the effect of that, and what expects those people? If you are running a business, if you're working for government, the real-time aspect is very, very important. This is a new factor that you need to integrate when you build your strategy, when you do business. People expect real time, and here we have the example of Uber, of course, that changed the game into the taxi business. Kodak was a big company, and Kodak disappeared. I saw on LinkedIn a few weeks ago Nokia CEO saying we fell. Okay, it was too fast for us. And Nokia was a monster. I mean, I was in Finland 20 years ago, and they had, the city was Nokia, So this is changing very, very, very quickly. Mobile is, the other revolution. So real-time, mobile, you see this picture where it's a concert. In 2005, people look at the scene, and today, they're taping that. And this is also affecting the way business is run today. Social is becoming a new media. So this picture, this stupid guy, okay, this is the first time we passed 1 billion views on YouTube. But it's also changing, the way if you want to operate business, if you want to communicate with customers, if you want to build products, these are very, very important factors. Real-time, mobile, and social becoming a new media. Some of interesting stats from Google. How many times people in the world are looking at their phone per day? Interesting stats. 150 times per day. Okay. And Facebook is saying that these 150 times correspond to 3 hours per day as an average in the world. You know, if you're a salesman, maybe for you it's more, you know. But yeah, this is definitely, this is new, this is changing the game, and it's a combination. It's the first time this year that you had more social media accounts in the world than email accounts. So we pass a bar, it's now, it's happening today. Interesting stat as well, okay? So expectations are changing, and you know, in this world of real time, social media can be used for customer service. It's a very nice use case, by the way, for that. But people expect fast answer, you know? So 60% of the people who complain via Twitter expect an answer within an hour. So if you're an organization, how can you build that? You know, this is the question. The KPI is 1 hour. You need teams, you need tools, you need education, you need training. And it's definitely a journey. It starts by, you know, understanding that factor and then putting in place the right strategy to answer that. So how to take the customer engagement to a new level? If we see all of that, okay, what can you do at a high level, okay, in order to improve the situation? If you look at the classic funnel of marketing in the past here, discover, explore, engage, and buy, it used to be very simple, okay? And if you want to follow your customer in the past, it was easy. Today, the touch points are like endless, okay? You can, you know, people can decide on Facebook, on review, in a store, on mobile. Look at the customer journey, I mean, it's massive today. So how is it possible today to be able to cope within this huge noise that is coming to customers, okay? How can you filter if you have something to say, if you're a government, if you're a company? How can you talk to this prospect, this customer, to the audience? This is an important question. So we have a lot of noise, and you know, if you look at social media, that is becoming the new media, TV is still there, but we have a switch, you know, to social media, definitely. We look at organic reach in social media. And in order to filter this noise, what happened recently is that the big social media network, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, changed their algorithm. It used to be that if you want to reach more customers, to have more fans on social media, this is the organic reach, you know, you could do this organically. Now you need to pay. They change the algorithm because they're becoming a new media, okay? It's funny to see that the pricing is starting to be a little bit similar to, you know, when you have a big spot on TV, you know, on prime time. You know, if you want to have a big splash, it's starting to be, you know, starting to be a little bit similar budget, getting very expensive. So there is another way that we want to talk today to, so, you know, we try to bring ideas also and to be able to reach customers where, you know, you have a paid strategy, it's expensive, but it's necessary, and more, this is definitely something you need to do. Organic is becoming very difficult, but one of the ways you can augment your reach that is very, very smart, is a very strong trend that is starting, you know, in the Western world, that Hootsuite is bringing also in the Middle East, is called employee advocacy. So you are working for an organization, you are working for a government, you have a marketing operation, you have strong message. Why not using the employee or the people working for your organization to relay your own social, your own marketing content, your message to their personal social network? So this is a very, very interesting trend because you have a huge scale effect if you try to do that. It's a project requiring tools, requiring expertise, but something for you to think about. So advocacy is a way to filter the noise. And Gartner is saying that a successful social marketer going forward will not just view social as an advertising channel only, but they will find the right balance between paid, organic, and advocacy efforts. And I don't think some of you knows too much about this advocacy thing, which is, you know, why we are bringing that today. Yeah. So, to understand what is advocacy, what is employee advocacy, when we talk to our customers, this is what we hear from them. This is the question that we hear. So, one of the questions that we hear from brand is, how do we increase the reach of our social media messages? Okay, this is. You know, maybe the new measurement of market share. I want to augment my reach, but I have a limited budget. I'm doing paid media. Organic is blocked now by social media network. How do I do that? Okay, this is my problem. This is a question we ask. One of the important questions here is how we can be seen as industry leaders. If you look at 20 years ago, if you go in a shop, you have a salesman, you ask questions, and he explains about products. Now, when you go to a shop, you know what you want. Maybe you explain to the sales rep what you want. Because you have been basically influenced by people, you know. And we saw that we have multiple touch points. So it moves from, you know, an old sales, old-fashioned mechanism to how can I be seen as an expert on my industry, on social media, so that people will go to you. You will attract people. Okay, so this is, but how to do this? Okay, so this is questions that are becoming strategic questions for organization. How to leverage mobile and social? We said, okay, the millennials, they're on mobile. Social is a new media. How, in a company, I can leverage the two? How I do this? Okay, question that we hear. We are in the digital transformation period where, you know, some companies think they are okay, that nothing can happen to them. But I think that, you know, we need to be careful because the world is changing very fast and we need to adapt to this new world. And one of the things that we see is that company trying to fight against disruption, one of the things they are trying to do is to educate their own employee. You cannot have a customer experience high level with a poor employee experience. It does not make sense, okay? So how I can scale social into my organization, how social can be used not only for marketing, but maybe for sales, maybe for HR. Of course HR, because where is the fish? You look at the fish, where is the fish, right? So if you look for talent, go where the talent are. And the young kid, they're on social media. So you need to talk to them, you need to be appealing. So this is a new way of organizing, you know, the company and the organizations. Definitely silo are the enemy, where you have marketing, not talking to sales, not talking to IT. In this type of organization, more modern, training is very important, and people are working on task, okay, to be able to reach goals and KPIs. So how I can scale that into my organization, question we hear, and ultimately, because this is something that is becoming more well known, how do I turn employee into brand advocates for my organization? Just to give you an idea, and this is an interesting example of why employee advocacy can resonate. Imagine you are a company with 200 people. Okay? Not a big company, not a small company. This company has 6,000 Facebook fans, 3,300 Twitter followers, and 250 LinkedIn followers. If you addition the three, you arrive to 9,550. This is the reach of this company. Remember that one of the questions that we hear is, how can I augment my reach? And the way today to augment the reach is to pay. But my budget is limited. So what's the solution? If I use my employee to relay my message, and of course, this is a project, you need good content, you need to explain to people why you do this. People will relay your message on their own social network because they will appear for their peer as specialists, as experts. Okay? I'm doing this for Hootsuite. We have a program like this of advocacy. It's a mobile app where you can relay to, you know, when I'm pushing the button to relay the marketing content from Hootsuite on my LinkedIn, it's searching, is reaching 6,000 people. It's amazing. We are 1,000 people in Hootsuite. If you do the multiplication, it's massive. So the multiplication is here. If 200 people in a company has an average of 200 Facebook friends, it's not a lot, 61 Twitter followers, and 240 average LinkedIn connection, in my example, I have 6,000, you do the multiplication, you arrive to a reach of 100,000. Okay? So it's a very, very smart way to augment your reach. It's also a very smart way to develop the engagement of your people into your company. Okay? Why I'm doing this? You know, first, because I like Hootsuite. I love this company. If I hate Hootsuite, I'm not doing that. So this is typically a project where HR is involved, marketing is involved, and you see where it's no longer a silo here. People are working together to form a social company. A social company is a company working together with the help of social media. Okay? So I receive very smart and innovative content from Hootsuite that I relay on my own social network. People say, hey, Olivier, you're an expert. You know? When I receive this message, I read this message. So I learn from my company. People spend fortune on intranet, on desktop. Nobody's going to intranet, right? People go on mobile. So if you have this information arriving on your mobile that you can relay, smart. Okay. So employee networks are valuable because if you do use your employee to relay your marketing message to their own social network, you increase your reach average by 500%. This is massive. Okay. 92% of employees' followers are new to the brand. My mother, she didn't know Hootsuite. Now she knows. My brother didn't know Hootsuite. Now he knows. Okay. And even if you're working for a big brand, usually people don't know exactly, you know, the message for the brand. You know, they know, for example, we are talking in Dubai about Abu Dhabi Airport. In Abu Dhabi about Abu Dhabi Airport. Okay, so people know it's an airport, but they have much more things to say that we are just an airport. Okay, so this is why, you know, it's also interesting. And you are much more willing to react and to engage to a message you receive from a friend than the message you receive from a brand. Okay? Because the message you receive from a brand, it's an advertising, you don't like it. If it's from a friend, it's your friend, and you read it. If employees are engaged into a program of employee advocacy, where, by the way, there is a very strong axis in training, in content strategy, okay? So it's a project based on tools and services. Well, if they do this of relaying, they are more keen on being close to your company and stay and be, you know, loyal to your organization. And at the end, more optimistic about their future. So into this employee advocacy project that are typical in social projects, you have a double effect. One is marketing. The other one is HR. And there are two different KPIs, very interesting for organizations. So just, you know, arriving maybe a little bit, few words on Hootsuite, because we are here, it's history for Hootsuite, the first time in Saudi, and we just established operation in Dubai. So we have this willingness to invest into Middle East. We have different offers. And it's interesting to see that we are very relevant for very small, medium and super big organization. And for the bigger organization, definitely we are helping organizations to develop their strategy into this digital transformation strategy. One of the unique things on Hootsuite, we just passed 2 weeks ago 15 million people using us. There is a big amount also in the Middle East. We are very well known for our freemium product, but as you can understand, we have also partnered with very large organizations in order to develop their social media strategy. It's interesting to see in the Middle East and for example in Saudi that you know we started by government here. Okay, so government is very keen on using Hootsuite in order to listen to the population and you know and to do customer service, for example, to start to interact, you know, with the population into a secure environment. So what we are trying to do for any type of organization is to help organization to grow and to deploy and to develop social media usage into the organization. It's often that the first step is the organization or the brand give the social media strategy to an agency. Maybe the agency is using Hootsuite. And then really our added value is when you start to internalize that, which is usually the classical step two, into the organization. And then we grow from few users to team usage to, you know, all the organization is using Hootsuite. Some of the typical use case, and it's a maturity model, from less mature to more mature. It's always the same journey. It's usually start by marketing, corporate communication, sales after that, employee advocacy, HR. One of the symptoms that an organization is very advanced on that is when you have the CEO that is connected to social media. You know, Elon Musk for Tesla, if you know this electric car company, Richard Branson for Virgin, by the way, Hootsuite customer. They are very active on social media. And when you have your CEO on social media, you want security. You want to protect against hacking. There's a big security chapter that we bring in Hootsuite. And it's funny to see that people don't see that yet. It reminds me Internet 20 years ago when, you know, we create our first web page. There is no firewall because we don't understand the problem. Today is exactly the same. So there are technology that are available to protect brands against hacking, you know, against the bad guys, right? So it's interesting to see that this is helpful to deploy massively into the organization. One of the things that we bring today, and is a very important announcement that Hootsuite is doing now, is that Hootsuite Enterprise, for large organization, is never working alone. We believe that it's impossible to be good on everything. So we partner with the best. We have a best of breed strategy, a little bit similar to Apple, you know, with the app. You know, we don't buy the iPhone just to the phone. You buy Apple for the app. So we are exactly the same. It's funny, by the way, to see that sometimes people bench Hootsuite and say, oh, you are missing this functionality. We have an app store of 164 technology. And this is giving us the ability to have very pertinent, relevant, regional offer. And today we are bringing and we are launching a partnership with a company called Crowd Analyzer in ArabNet, Riyadh. And they are an incredible Arab startup, originally based in Egypt. You know, the project started where, you know, into our market, into social media strategy, one of the first things that you want to do is listen. Listen to the web to see what people are saying at the moment on you. They don't talk to you. They talk between themselves about you, okay? And they talk a lot, right? But this technology that is called deep listening has been built by company from US, from France, from Western world, and from the UK, and they consider Arabic as one language. It's a problem. One of the functionality that people love is to say, okay, I want a keyword. I want to see if my brand, people like it or they don't like it. Okay? It's called sentiment analysis. Okay? I want to see if it's good, bad, or neutral. crawling millions of mentions, meaning people talking on social media, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, for example. I want to see, like that, if it's positive or negative. Sentiment analysis. And it's a common sense to say, it's impossible to do it in Arabic, because Arabic is too complex, because the same sentence in Arabic, you know, in different contexts, has a different meanings. So everybody says it's impossible. It's possible. Because starting from, you know, this technological issue, this company coming from the Western world did not build the algorithm for Arabic. They built it, you know, for, you know, non-Arabic languages. So this company called CrowdAnalyzer, originally based in Egypt, so very advanced technology based on, originally it's a machine learning artificial intelligence technology dedicated to build a product for social media listening in Arabic. We are now 2 years after, you know, the creation of that. I think they've been awarded at ArabNet, by the way. And we announced today the integration of CrowdAnalyzer in Hootsuite so that you have a 360-degree solution to listen to what people say in Arabic dialect and English. And then when you listen, it's giving you insight to publish and then maybe to engage with people. All this in a secure platform that is called Hootsuite. I think we are the only one today, you know, capable to say that. It's very, very strong. And I can tell you that all the bench we have done, you know, against the industry today is like is amazing. We have a stand. You can visit us here. So yeah, CrowdAnalyzer is giving you you know, deep analysis in terms of sentiment analysis, dialects. You can do things that you cannot normally do. For example, I want to do a survey. I want to do a survey for, you know, based on gender on Twitter, you know, in Arabic. You cannot do this via Twitter. You can do this with this product. So relevancy into Arabic. This is very, very, you know, important message. And the Alliance is launched today. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Olivier. I just like to run some points with you guys. What's happening right next is a CEO series taking place in Hall A. The interview, it's a one-on-one interview with the CEO of Sadad, Mr. Abdel Malik Sheikh, followed by a panel discussion. And last but not least, we have the awards ceremony where we'll be announcing the winners of the Startup Battle, Ideathon, and Battle of the Games competitions. Now I would like to invite you to lunch. We have 1 hour lunch break and we'll kick back off in Hall A. Everything related to digital media marketing track has ended for today. Thank you so much.